everyone here tonight has been invited to have a meal on us. They know they're being filmed, but they can't see the cameras. Everything you're about to see is real.
I'll definitely be one of them men walking around the streets pissed and...
Oh, I used to be in Slade, mate.
Do you remember this one? So it is! Right. Was that where we're sitting?
Yes. Your chair, or do you want me to hang out?
Be all right. I've got all my bits and dabs in it and all my cigarettes and things. Got to get my glasses out. Good food here.
It's gorgeous.
Is it?
And I'm not just saying that.
Are you going to recommend what's the best?
I can certainly guide you through the menu. Would you like anything to drink to start with?
Oh, yes. But, I've been watching that Ozzy programme. His kids just really annoy me.
Kids. It's funny, though.
He's brilliant. The kids play up too much.
I can't think of another person, certainly in the rock and roll business, that could have done that other than Ozzy, that could have pulled it off. He don't tell jokes or anything. It's just the things that have happened to him in his career.
Is he from the same place as you?
Yes, from Aston in Birmingham. But I'm from Worcester, which is on about
did you
five
know him
mile
then?
Away. Yeah, we knew him in the 60s. But I mean, I used to go drinking with him. Loads of times. I never passed out with him. Because I could keep up with him drinking.
Yeah,
but most people would pass out with him. And his favourite trick, if you passed out with him...
Eyebrows.
He would shave the eyebrows off.
But no, he'd run along, wouldn't he? But every
optic behind the bar.
And would drink a pint
he'd
of it?
He'd put a pint glass and then knock it back.
You didn't do that?
Yeah, I did it.
Why is he not dead?
Do you not miss making music, then?
I suppose I do in a way, but I don't miss all the... I don't miss all the hassle that go with it.
When's the last time you wrote a song?
I think in this day and age, it'd be interesting to see how a band like us would survive in this day and age in the corporate structure of things and... The pretty boy.
I'm just wondering how you'd be lying now if you'd stuck with it.
There is nobody around like us now.
I do think that's really extraordinary about the Slade, because people don't get what Slade were about at all. They remember the worst songs
people.
Of Slade, don't they? Like Merry Christmas Everybody, it's your worst song, isn't it?
No, it's not.
It is.
No way.
Troll it out every year. You know your other songs are miles, miles better than that.
But certainly not the worst song we ever did. Come on. It's only you thinking that because over the years you're probably fed up of it. But no way is it.
It's a novelty record.
It's not a novelty record. That record was number one in France in the Easter following when it had come out in Britain.
Was it?
And they didn't realise it was about Christmas.
What, Merry Christmas Everybody?
Yeah, but to them... It was a great pop rock record.
How much would you reform Slade for?
I would never. I've had phenomenal offers to reform Slade.
One off.
It wouldn't work.
£10 million, do it.
Too much water gone under the bridge.
Yeah, you're just frightened that people think you look stupid.
Yeah, but we're all like, we don't have any contact now, really, particularly. We don't. You know, we're all on different wavelengths now. I've not spoken to Dave and Don for probably 2 years. Well, they haven't spoken to me for 2 years. I've seen Jim occasionally. You hear about things that happen to other bands all the time. You know, bands that fall out and the history of bands and whatever. And I would never have thought that what has happened to us would have happened. I mean, we had a letter from Don and Dave saying we want no contact directly to them. It all has to go through our life. But what's all that about? We were together for 25 years.
At 15 minutes
with... Have your own Christmas
record. 15 minutes with Jagger. 15 minutes. It was like stopwatch. And we get this guy saying, Mick requests that you don't talk... No lifestyle questions. I said, so I can't say shagging Sophie Dahl at the minute then. And he just, nervous laugh. So he just kept it straight. But somebody said, right, my mate.
Well, you see, he probably wouldn't bother about being questioned about stuff like that.
I was told beforehand about his hair. The same hairdresser does Bowie and Jagger. There's a guy in Paris, right?
Right.
And then, you know, there's this question of David Bowie's receding hairline and Jagger's. But Jagger, if it's a wig, right, Jagger's hair, and I was looking, just trying to catch a bit of light coming through it, but it looked like it was a good, if he's bald or if it's
good Irish.
Very good. It's even got flecks of grey in it. So it must be his own, mustn't it?
Slade had the fair share of syrups.
There was only one, wasn't there? Really? Was there two? That's very interesting. Dave Hill, yeah, because that was a complete wig, wasn't it? I reckon Don.
No.
Don was his. So you said two syrups in the band. Oh, it must be Jimmy. Are you winding me up?
I've already been told.
What, now or then?
Partly then, but I don't know.
That's brilliant. That's the best piece of gossip I've heard in ages.
I mean, they have got great humour, Oasis.
Yeah. But Liam's funny.
Great strong humour. Very, very I read funny. An interview with them in Q, the two of them.
Oh, they, when those two get
so
together,
fucking they're funny.
He is great.
But there ain't many bands that have humour.
Eminem?
Yeah. He's funny.
He's like the Benny Hill of the rap generation, isn't he, Eminem?
Yeah, I'll write him.
Do you?
Yeah.
But it's not
lyrically.
Well, everyone says that, you know.
It's poetry in its own way. I mean, my generation shouldn't like him. He'd probably hate it to think that my generation liked him. I find it very funny.
You wouldn't put it on, would you, at home?
I would, because it makes me laugh. It's clever.
Why'd you put a record on to have a laugh?
But it's clever. That's why I love Britain. It is. I love these nutters. I just love these nutters who do things.
Well, the great British eccentric.
In America, you get the eccentrics, but they're not lovable eccentrics.
Oh, you mean like Patrick Moore?
I think they're a dying breed, that. Like Milligan and all that.
You'll end up like that. Mad as
I'm going that
cheese.
Way. I will end up mad.
I don't think you realise how crackers you are all the time. You've no idea.
I'll definitely be one of them men walking around the streets pissed and.
Well, I used to be in Slade, mate.
Remember this one? So it is.